गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट. एज आई स्टार्टेड माई रिविजन क्लास, सो हियर ऑल्सो दैट कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ द रिविजन क्लास. नाउ सी, एज इन द फर्स्ट क्लास आई सेड व्हाट दैट इज दैट एंगल ऑफ डेविएशन फॉर प्रिज्म वी हैव टू डू द फॉर्मूला आई नीड टू रिमेम्बर फॉर न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम एज वेल एज द डिडक्शन वी नीड टू डू. हियर द सेम क्वेश्चन. When a light ray passes through a prism, then show that the angle of deviation delta equal to I1 plus I2 minus A, where symbols have their usual meaning. Nothing else, I need to prove the formula. That's we had done in class, but since it is revision class, I will do it again, but not vividly. I will give you a quick recapitulation on that. Achha. What is the trick to prove this formula? First trick is that draw the diagram very neat and clean, because otherwise you can't understood the diagram, you can't establish the triangle, quadrilateral, and you can't prove it. So first what we'll do, I'm showing you, I'm drawing a large prism. So I think that is quite big, you can understood very well. So this is a prism. So this is angle of prism A. Clear? See, normally incidence ray, then reflection, then again a reflection, refraction. Incidence, then refraction, then again a refraction. But since I need to score a good mark in exam, so I will do with a trick. What is the trick? First, draw a parallel line with respect to this base. This will be the path of refraction. Done? Because this is very crucial. If it is not perfectly parallel, you can't establish that. So this is my incidence ray. Done. This is the second refraction. So first incidence, then refraction, then again an incidence over here, then refraction. Done. Now I need to draw normal. Now it is a tilt surface, little bit inclination, so normal also will be a inclined one. So here a normal, and also here I will have another normal. No confusion. Done. Two normal done. Now if there is no prism, so this ray will moving along this direction. And if there is no prism, this ray will move along this direction. So elongate this ray little bit along this, and this ray along this a little bit like this. Done. So actually, if I saw clearly carefully, what is happening? If there is no prism, so this ray will propagate along this direction. Incidence ray. Clear? This is the final refraction. So this ray will propagate along this direction if there is no prism. But since there is prism, clear, this ray should follow along this, but ray is moving along this. So this one is what? This one, this angle is my angle of deviation delta. Done. So my diagram complete. It's a perfect diagram. In my PDF, probably a little bit changes are there. So you do this perfectly, okay? In class we have done. So let's give the name. So this is my incident ray OP. Then it follow the path PQ. Then QR. Done. Now first thing first. This is normal. Clear? This is my incident ray. So this angle is I1. First angle of incidence. Then it is moving towards this. This is the normal. So this is what? This is what? Can you tell me? This one is angle of refraction. First angle of refraction. Now this ray propagating along this direction falls over here. Second angle of incidence. Here I am taking is at R2. Why R2? Why not I2? Because inside prism I can't measure angle. So intentionally I am writing here R, which I can measure here. So then the ray bends towards this direction. Clear? Ray bends towards this direction. So my next will be my angle of emergence. angle of emergence or angle of second refraction will be I2. That's done. Now the meeting point of this OP towards this and this one I am taking as M and I am taking as N. Clear? Done. That's all. Now I am taking this angle as delta 1 and this angle as delta 2. Clear? Now coming for the first triangle. Now see, this is MPQ is a triangle. MPQ is a triangle. This is the outside angle. We know from triangular theorem the outside angle is the sum of these two angles. So delta can be written as delta 1 plus delta 2. No confusion, delta can be written as delta 1 plus delta 2. Done. Now, okay, no confusion, delta is delta 1 plus delta 2. Now, coming for the angle of incidence. Now, see, this is my angle of incidence. Clear? So, if there is no prism, so these are the opposite angle, means this I should be equal to normal, this ray. And this whole angle should equal to each other, means I1 and R1 plus delta 1 are the opposite angles. So from here what I can write, I1 equal to R1 plus delta 1. So from there I can write delta 1 equal to I1 minus R1, first thing done. Similarly coming here, so if there is no refraction, so obviously this angle should equal to that 2 angle. So here also I2 equal to I2 equal to R2 plus delta 2 or delta 2 equal to I2 minus R2. So this is again another one. So I will put it over here. So therefore delta equal to, put here in this equation, that is I1 minus R1 plus I2 minus R2, that is equal to I1 plus I2 minus R1 plus R2. As I am saying that I can't measure the inside angle R1 R2, I can measure the outside angle. Because inside prism, how could I measure? It's not possible, feasible. So I need to eliminate that R1, R2. How I will eliminate that? Now coming to the diagram. See, I am having so many things here. First of all, if it is a quadrilateral, who is the quadrilateral? A, P, N, Q, A. This is a quadrilateral, means A, P, N, Q is a quadrilateral. Quadrilateral means what? Quadrilateral means all angles together makes 360 degree. So from that quadrilateral, angle A plus this angle is what? NPA. This angle is NPA. This angle is NPA. So angle A, this is my first angle, quadrilateral I am considering now. And second angle is APN, this is the next angle. So plus angle APN, next angle, angle PNQ, angle PNQ, plus next angle is angle NQA. NQA plus angle NQA, that is equal to 360 degree. So I am having this quadrilateral from this, can you see? So APNQ from that quadrilateral I can write that. Now in between all these angles, few will be already eliminated. Who are they? First of all, see, if you see carefully, this angle means this is a 90 degree angle, means since this is normal, so if it is normal, this angle making 90 degree with this surface, this whole angle is 90 degree and this whole angle also 90 degree. Clear? means angle APN, in place of angle APN I can put 90 degrees. So here I will put 90 degrees. Next, angle AQN, this is also what? Normal. So AQN or NQA, this is also 90 degrees. So write it down. So remaining term is that is